is a bloody space boy.
10 years. You think for what? You're playing some dumb victim. It was going to Tom Jones. Tom Jones. You've heard of Tom Jones, right?
Can we just play some real music? Seriously, guys?
Okay, Speedy. Just completing the orbit now.
You got a good sensor sweep?
Good sweep here, Cap. Sheriff's found some sweet veins in the data.
Pay dirt!
Alright. We're 6 months off. We're looking good, boys. Okay. I'm gonna take her up into the higher orbit for the last sweep of the day. Smitty, what was that?
I don't know, boss.
Smitty, you're my chief engineer. You're supposed to know.
Okay, it's Audrey's way of telling you. How dies in Hobbit?
Hey, now don't be talking about Audrey like that. She's been good to us more than 10 years.
Oh, yeah. I just don't know how. Look, all she needs is just some tender, loving care. Now, if she was like, let's say, a larger ship, like, let's say, an Audrey 2, or it would be like, feed me, feed me, all the time. And of course, you did name the ship after an ex-girlfriend, which dumped you like a minging sack of...
Hey, it's called turning a negative into a positive.
You say so.
Oh, sorry, Smitty, incoming message. Kate! There's a face I haven't seen in a while.
Hey, it's been too long, Mike. You look good. Hey, are you still doing mineral survey business aboard the Audrey?
Still going at it. What are you up to these days?
Right now, the Hercules is very busy keeping the Parkesh pirates in check here.
Well, corporate government wants to keep the trade lanes open.
You know how it is. Fleet Command isn't supposed to be subject to the whims of government, but they are under a lot of pressure.
Well, just be careful. Parkesh have never taken kindly to interference, and they can be pretty nasty.
If they wouldn't interfere themselves, we'd get along just fine. They set up a blockade at the Rendor mining colony. We're on our way there to check things out.
It's always something.
Well, this could work out well for you, though, Mike. Captain Boone gave me the go-ahead to contact you guys. How would you like to make some extra credits for an easy job?
I'd want to run any job by my crew. They're not ones that turn down extra credits, especially with time off just around the corner.
Thought so. So we picked up an anomaly on our long-range sensors. Leads to some sort of space disturbance. We can't make out much more than that. Fleet Command doesn't want to take the pressure off the Parkesh, so we're stuck here. You're the only other ship in the area with the equipment to do it. Now, you'd be doing the job under standard Fleet Command contract terms. But it's a good deal, Mike.
I like it. It's just what this crew needs right now.
Good. The coordinates of the anomaly are, Mr. Sorbo?
8026x1165x2202.
Thanks. Got it?
Got it.
Listen, Mike. As with any alien phenomenon, at the first sign of trouble, get your ship out of there. There could be Parkesh around as well. Just survey and report.
Don't worry. We're big on self-preservation here.
That's what I like to hear. Take care, Captain Bradley. I hope to hear from you soon.
Same to you, Rhonda. Attention all hands, this is your fearless leader. Could be a staff meeting in the lounge after the last survey of the day.
Oh, joy.
Engine sorted out. Shifted.
Free! Free!
Computer, begin recording.
Recording.
I hereby call this crew meeting to order. 182 days since departure. We'll begin with roll call. Captain Mike Bradley.
Chief Engineer Aaron Smith.
Chief Medical Officer Lyra Gonzalez.
Daniel Witherspoon, Survey Specialist.
Why are we doing these roll calls, Ken?
Computer, pause recording.
Recording.
Because, again,
CEO of Mine Corps is former Fleet Command. He likes to follow Fleet Command protocol, and I like keeping my job.
I get that. But you realize the only way attendance is ever going to change at one of these meetings is if one of us dies?
There's a happy thought. Hey, Cap, can we put speeding in charge of morale?
Hey, you know what would be a big morale booster? Some flight time. That'd be a big morale booster here. What?
Speedy. Do we really need to go over the incident at Starport 17 again?
Anyone can have a bad day.
Firing thrusters while the ship is still docked
is not just having a bad day.
It was a minor mishap!
That sure wasn't a minor repair.
It could have happened to anyone!
And yet, that is the only time it has ever happened there.
I ask you, are we docked now?
Once again, you've completely missed the point.
Hey, Cap, help me out. Can I get a little flight time?
No.
Fine. When I get back home, I'll talk to my therapist about my depression, my lack of career development here.
A mineral survey ship this far from home isn't the best place for career development.
Stifling continues.
Can we move on now?
All the motion tonight.
Now we're getting somewhere. Computer, continue recording.
I move that alcohol be served at every meeting from now on.
Yeah!
Oh, Smitty, you're bad enough sober.
And what is that supposed to mean?
Computer, stop and delete recording.
Recording, stop.
We go through this every trip out, gang. We're near the end of a long mission, and we're all getting a little bit cranky.
A little bit?
Okay, more than a little bit. How about some extra pay to take the edge off?
Hey, extra pay is always a morale booster here.
So what's the plan?
I just heard from Commander Cage of the Hercules.
Cage, huh? Well, hey, that is one battle-hardened lady.
She's had more than her share of casualties, too.
You hear the color of the black widow?
I don't want to hear it, Speedy.
Just making an observation.
Well, keep that observation to yourself.
Fine. I had enough angst for my therapy session back home anyway.
She gets a bad rap. She's always acted with honor and bravery, which is more than sometimes can be said for Fleet Command. And she's my friend.
Fair enough.
Let's get back to the offer of a little Fleet Command contract work.
Hey, that's good pay.
And it's simple, too. We just need to survey a space anomaly and report. That's all.
What kind of space anomaly?
If they knew that, they wouldn't need us to go check it out.
I mean, really, who cares? Look, forget it. Look, I'll take a little Fleet Command pay for a little sweep and leap job. Any day of the week.
Yeah. Am I right?
Yeah.
Am I right?
All right. Well, let's wrap up here then, and we'll be on our way in 4 hours.
Right. Let's do it. Hey, Cap.
Too bad you weren't able to get that meeting recorded. It's such a breach of Fleet Command protocol.
It's okay, Speedy. I mean, it's not like I tried to fire thrusters while still docked at Starport.
Why, you never let that go!
Nice.
Hey, thanks for shedding the load handling Speedy back there.
They're all restless.
They'll be okay once we're back home and they get 6 months off. Hey,
I'm gonna get a little jump out, some rest and relaxation.
What? I can't get a little preview?
You sound just like Speedy. I'm a little restless too. I get that way after 6 months on a ship named after your ex-girlfriend.
You know, we've been over this 100 times. It has nothing to do with her. It has to do with moving forward, leaving the past behind. I've been okay with this before. What's wrong?
It isn't just that. We were talking about marriage before we left, and we haven't talked about it since. It's like you're married to this ship and a treasure hunting.
Do you even notice me anymore?
Of course I do.
Mike, you notice that football more than you notice me.
I'm just like focused on that work. I mean, you know, I do have responsibilities as captain of the show.
Oh, so now I'm a distraction?
Very beautiful distraction I care about more than anything else.
But still a distraction.
No! Okay. Maybe I could have worded that better. Let's fight.
Look. Maybe it was nothing more than me being restless like the others. What? Let's just stick to business. For now. We can work this out when we get home. It won't be that long. I need time to think.
Right. Okay. If that's what you want.
But when you're ready to talk, I'll be here. Anytime.
Thanks.
Speedy's personal journal. If Mike throws that football at my head one more time, just one more time.
Personal journal entry, Mike Bradley. Captain, she needs time to think, she says. Time to think? I thought we were doing good. I really thought we were doing good. She goes and she pulls this. I mean, it's my job. I'm captain of the ship. I've got responsibilities. You know, when she puts her duties as chief medical officer first, I don't say she's not paying attention to me. I don't even feel like I can talk to Smitty about this. Everybody's just been so on edge lately. 6 months out here is just too long. You know, I'm glad everybody lightened up at news of the fleet contract at least, but I don't want this affecting the crew negatively. You know, we've come so far over the past few years, really come together as a team. Easily the best crew the Audrey's ever had, and even Smitty would admit that. We've gelled these past couple years. I mean, I'd say at this point, we've surveyed more planets than any other sweepers team for Mine Corps, and it's a damn sight better than working for Fleet these days. I don't know how Philip does it. You know, he says he's going to have command of his own fleet comm ship by the end of the year. I mean, he probably will, but when my tour ended with Fleet, I could not wait to get out from under their thumb. I don't know how he does it. Props to you, big bro. Phil was even saying the whole family's getting together next month at Dad's ranch on Payless Prime. I was thinking of finally introducing Lear to everybody, but, you know, we'd kind of have to still be in a relationship. I don't know. Maybe we do need time to think. Maybe I need time to think. Time to throw the football at Speedy. Yeah, you know, this contract's just what we need. A little more time, it's easy money, and we're back home.
Right then. Ship's personal log, chief engineer and Smith recording. Well, here we are. About to do one last thing, you know, checking out a little anomaly somewhere out there before we head into the bottom, you know, doing a favor for Commander Cage and Fleet Command. Shouldn't be too bad, I mean, it's just a nice little sweeping leap. So, basically, we're in, we're out, no mucking about, then we're home for 6 months, which is good. Very good thing. Yeah, really good thing. I mean, between Speedy
dragging the Audrey a bit. Over in Starport 17. Good lord, if he gets within another 4 feet of my controls one more time, I'm putting him up in an EV suit while we're going slipstream. And I'm going to put him within inches, just inches of the damn shield so he gets an idea what not to do when doing thrusters in space dock. That aside, we all need a downtime. Yeah. I mean, between Lyra and Mike getting all dog and cats and all that, and ship getting all dodgy on the shifts. Yeah, the downtime will do us all good. That's all. A wee bit of downtime. Right. Spit out.
Side and whatever lies beyond it.
That's not going to make for a very informative report.
At least we get paid.
I'd like to make that pay worthwhile for Fleet Command if I can.
It seems to deflect most of the energy from the sensors, though, rather than letting it pass through.
You suggested a veil. Could it be a cloaked Pakesh ship?
Whoa! Hey, guys, no! No, I am not dealing with any Parkesh.
No, a cloaked Parkesh vessel wouldn't be detectable on sensors. This is.
So, nothing more to go on?
Well, the energy deflection rate is not 100%. With fine-tuning, I can get an energy reading from beyond it, but it is so faint. I can't make out what it is even at maximum power. To get a better reading, we'd have to get closer.
How much closer?
I'd say decrease the distance by 90%.
Mike, is it wise to get that close?
No sign of any trouble so far. I don't see why not.
I just have a bad feeling about this.
You always get a bad feeling, Lyra.
Yeah, Speedy, like you nearly jumped at the word Parkesh.
I'll go take the ship up to the front door. Can you make it up better now, Sharpie?
There's definitely some sort of energy source beyond the barrier, Captain. Strange.
Oh, it's sensor great is being there one minute,
and then not the next, and then there again. I don't understand it.
Can you make anything out about the energy source itself?
These energy readings aren't like anything I've ever seen before.
Boy, breathe,
wait. The energy of the... It's moving through the barrier.
Let's get out of here, Mike.
It's coming directly toward us! Oh, bloody hell!
Signs are slowly fading. It's as if the energy is being drained out of his body. And there's something else. My scanner keeps losing its lock on Mike, as if he's fading in and out of existence.
Like the energy reading on the other side of the barrier.
How is this possible? What are you reading, Sharpie?
Speedy. Link the Lyra's scanner and route it to my console.
Got it. Done.
It's not a coincidence. Each time the image of the captain fades here, the energy reading on the other side of the barrier appears. Each time the energy reading on the other side of the barrier disappears, you see the captain again here. It's definitely a correlation.
What is going on?
And that's not all. Each time... With each cycle of appearance and fading of the captain, the appearance gets shorter, and the time that we don't see him gets longer. It's maybe a tenth or a twentieth of a second each time that we don't see him, but the rate is slowly increasing.
No, this is not good. No.
I don't like the sound of that.
It is if he is slowly moving towards the other side of the barrier.
Yes, that's my thinking as well.
My good guys, no. This is not good.
If you're correct about this,
How much longer does he have until the transfer is complete?
Assuming the rate of increase doesn't change, I'd say about 5 minutes.
What can we do?
I'm open to suggestions. We don't even know what we're dealing with here.
Look, I can try to learn more from the scanners.
We don't have time for that.
What's that? We're being scanned! The computer, the ship, everything!
Through the barrier?
No, it's from this side, but I can't tell where it's coming from.
Vera, no!
No more than Zalas. No, Lyra Gonzalez.
But I have to help him!
And it may well come to pass that you will, but this is not the way. If you were to come in contact with the energy field that surrounds Michael Bradley, you would be drawn into the rift, and then we would have two people to retrieve.
Who are you?
For now, I will say that I am a friend who is here to help. There is no time for more. With each passing moment, it becomes more difficult to retrieve Michael Bradley. I will use the power of my scepter to attempt to pull Michael Bradley from the rift back to the ship. You must trust me, Lyra Gonzalez, Aaron Smith, Daniel Witherspoon, and Donald Holland.
We don't have any other options.
Yes! Bring our captain back, please! Please!
Yes! Please! This came over.
You have to hurry. Mike can't die!
Please join the others, Lyra Gonzalez, so that you may be safe from the power of the scepter.
Thank you.
transfer is slowing. But not stopping.
My sense tells me that as well.
Will we be able to get Mike back?
I don't think so.
The transfer will slow about 80% before picking up speed again.
Again, my sense is in agreement.
How much longer does he have now?
I'd say about an hour.
Through half that time, the difficulty in retrieving Michael Bradley will remain constant. Beyond that, it will become increasingly difficult.
That's assuming that the power of the scepter remains constant.
It will. It is providing all the energy that it can. We have 25 minutes to discuss this until a decision must be made.
What decision?
Let us talk first, Lyra Gonzalez, so that you know what you need to know to make that decision.
Talk?
First, from my scan of your information store, I believe you are familiar with the concept of non-interference with a less developed society?
We are.
Absolutely. History has taught us that, even with well intentions, interference can have disastrous consequences.
Admirable. My people believe strongly in such a policy as well, and that is why I must not make you aware of knowledge that is beyond your current level of development. Do not take offense where none is intended. If I seem to oversimplify or withhold information, I am just being cautious. I'm looking out for your well-being.
We understand.
Thank you for being so considerate.
I will tell you what I can. Do not be deceived by my appearance. You cannot assimilate my true form. I have created one that is suitable for you. You cannot pronounce my true name, nor that of my planet. I will give you their substitutes. I am a Zolaran from the planet Zolar. You may call me Zol. And you may call our mutual nemesis Law.
Is there a connection between you and Lar?
Sadly, yes. Zolarans have developed a method of space travel that is far more advanced than yours. Lar has devoted much of his life to the development of an improved method of travel. He believed he had done just that, but testing of the new method revealed a fatal flaw. Any attempt to use it creates a rift in space that cannot be traversed. One can only reverse course and return. Funding for research was discontinued. It was thought that was the end of it.
So, Lar didn't stop. Kind of obvious.
No. Lar could not accept failure. He found other sources of funding and continued his work in secret. Much time passed, then Lar announced he had found a solution. We knew this was not possible. There are certain laws of space travel that precluded any means of traversing a rift.
Is what is happening to Mike an attempt by Lar to escape the rift?
Yes. What Lar is trying to do is horrifying to any Zolaran. He has somehow convinced himself that he can move beyond the rift by drawing a life form into it and exchanging places on the other side. We know with certainty that this is not possible. The laws of space travel cannot be broken.
Well, it looks like you already found someone to draw into the rift.
Yes, Donald Holland. But once the transfer is complete, there is no way back here for Michael Bradley or Lar. Michael Bradley would be trapped on the other side of forever, and there is no place for him there. The differences there are too great for him to assimilate. That is why Michael Bradley must be retrieved before it is too late.
But how, Zol? You haven't been able to reverse the transfer with your scepter. You just slowed it down temporarily.
True, Lyra Gonzalez. Lar has the advantages of proximity and the barrier. In order to overcome those advantages, we must find an anchor here that can be used to draw him back. I believe you are that anchor, Lyra Gonzalez. My sense tells me you have very strong feelings for Michael Bradley.
Yes, I do.
And Michael Bradley has similar strong feelings for you?
Yes, he does.
Your feelings channeled as energy through my scepter will make a connection to Michael Bradley that grounds him to this place and draws him back.
Well, what are we waiting for?
There must be some sort of risk or there will be no decision to make.
Correct, Daniel Witherspoon. In order to channel the energy, Lyra Gonzalez and I must wield the scepter together for a period of time. The scepter produces great power. The power will sap energy from Lyra Gonzalez, weakening her. She may not survive.
Is there a way to determine a level of risk?
There is. Approach, Lyra Gonzalez. We will perform two tests. You will place your hand on the scepter and keep it there until the first sense of weakness, and then withdraw it immediately.
Is it safe?
These tests pose no risk. You will not be in contact with the scepter long enough to be in any danger. Do you understand what is to be done, Lyra Gonzalez?
I do.
Are you ready?
I am.
Place your hand on the scepter.
Whoa! That comes on quickly. One moment I was fine, and then the next I was suddenly weak.
That is just as I expected. It should pass just as quickly.
Yeah, it has.
Good, good. For the second test, take my hand with one hand and place your other hand on the scepter. Remember to withdraw at the first sign of weakness. From these two tests, I sense you are equally as likely to survive as not to survive, Lyra Gonzalez.
Wait, we're talking 50-50 here.
It's definitely a risky proposition.
The decision is yours to make, Lyra.
I'll do it. I have to help Mike.
It is admirable that you accept such risk on another's behalf, Lyra. Kneel before the scepter. Grasp the scepter firmly with both hands and focus with all of your concentration on bringing Michael Bradley back to the ship.
Come back to me!
He is free. We have won. I have created a field of healing energy around Lyra Gonzalez and Michael Bradley. It will dissipate in a few hours. They will both need complete rest for a few days. However, they will recover fully.
Who are you?
Do not talk, Michael Bradley. You must do nothing but rest for now. I am a friend. The others can tell you about me later. Now I must take my leave. Every moment I am here risks interference. Much damage was already done.
Thank you for all that you have done.
We are certainly most grateful for your help.
Never forget.
Thank you.
Quiet, Lyra Gonzalez. You are welcome. It may be centuries before you have advanced enough to interact with my people safely. You do show great promise. You understand and appreciate the concept of non-interference. You are willing to risk your lives on behalf of others. You show great promise indeed. When the time is right, we will make proper contact. Farewell.
You know, I have a feeling that Zalarans have knowledge far beyond things that we've even thought of yet.
Yeah, we must have made quite an impression on her for her to even think we have any promise at all.
You know, it is said that what truly defines us is our drive to improve ourselves.
True. And speaking of improvements, I believe some is seriously needed after the shaking down this ship has gone through. So, I will be making a thorough inspection to see what needs to be repaired.
Alright, I'll head to Med Bay and make sure it's ready to receive Mike and Lyra as soon as they're ready to move.
Righto.
Yeah, I'll fly the ship.
No! Stifle! I tell ya, stifle!
Very speedy.
I heard you say that all the bones.
crazy. You got Mike and Lyra are back together. You got Smitty is smitten with the ship. And you got Sharps who's... You know what? He was a good high foot, so at least he's got that going on. And me? Well, I got a rock.